back again for the second chest, shoulder, tricep and calf session of the week. And starting with calves as usual. If I don't do them first, I'll probably skip them or train them like a little bitch. So you've got four sets of these. The only downside is when I do standing calf raises, my feet always start to slip or slide. So I have to constantly, like, mid-set readjust them. But, yeah, outside of that, honestly, I'd have to say standing calf raises is probably my favourite calf raise variation. Donkey calf raises are close second, and then seated dead last. But the reason I like standing, or even like the horizontal calf press, is just because you're getting better stimulus of the entire calf, like a lot of gastroc, a lot of soleus involved, because your knee is fully extended when you're performing the actual exercise. So yeah, but not much to really say about them. Like, calves are just one of those body parts where, like, they're not more stubborn to growth per se, like they are more slow twitch fiber dominant, which means that they can handle more volume, they recover quicker between sets and also between sessions, so you can hit them more frequently and hit them harder. But outside of that, it's just a matter of just making sure that you train them hard. People just tend to half-ass their calf training. People focus a lot on their arm training and half-ass body parts that they either don't see significant, or they don't see them as significant body parts, but that's the reason why they're so insignificantly developed a lot of the time for people. They just don't have that same level of attention to detail when they're doing their training for that body part compared to the body part that they love or that they can see or that they really want to bring up. At the end of the day, muscle's a muscle and it gets bigger or smaller. Now, I'm not entirely sure what happened on that last set. I did record the third set, but it just didn't work. Oof. 12 down, 5 to go. First chest exercise. Perfect fly. And I actually really liked this exercise last time. I feel it a lot in the chest and not really much in the shoulders at all. Put my sternum pop there on the first rep. I'm falling apart, I tell you. Need to grip incline press now, or parallel grip. Ugh. So I want to go heavier than 180 pounds, but I also don't want to tear my chest again, so I'll just stick to this weight until I get all of my working sets for the max number of reps, with a few reps in the tank to spare. And once I do, I'll increase the weight a little bit. It's probably worth noting and mentioning too, because this is something that a lot of people don't think about. When you're pressing, you really want to use the chest as much as possible, and that can sometimes be a bit difficult if you're just focusing on pressing with the arms and just thinking about like pressing and then locking the elbows out. What you also want to think about doing is driving your spine backwards into the bench as you simultaneously press away. Almost kind of like you're trying to, like, imagine the handles are like the ground and you're trying to push off the ground. I like to do that in addition to pressing with the arms and locking the elbows out and contracting the chest. Try to think about like driving some force, backward force, from my back into the back support. And it just helps me recruit my chest that much more. You'll find that you won't be able to do as many reps or as much load, but you'll get a better contraction with your chest, I can assure you that. Just make sure that you're still getting a decent stretch on the negative. But the retraction or the shoulders back, chest up, is really important on the stretch. But on the press, you don't want to completely restrict scapular movement. I think that's part of the reason why I tore my chest a couple of weeks ago in the first place. I started trying to lift too much like how Mike Isratel from Renaissance Periodization advocates pressing. And although I get what he's trying to say, I get the point he's trying to make, if you're eccentrically loading your chest too much and just focusing on loading in that stretch and not so much in that contracted position, and you can't truly get into a fully contracted chest position without a little bit of protraction, a little bit of reaching or a little bit of posterior expansion. So if you're limiting that, if you're not letting the shoulders come forward a little bit and you're trying to keep them pinned back the whole time, you're not going to fully achieve that full shortening of the chest, in my opinion, and that can potentially lead to some issues down the track. And I think that is part of the reason why I tore my chest, in addition to just general overreaching. But okay, so I'm keeping this exercise very light because it places the chest in such a stretch position, shoulder in a bit of a, I suppose, disadvantageous position. There we go, that's better. Thought it was a little bit too narrow. Thank you. Okay, so keeping this exercise light, just doing a higher rep range, and yeah. The handles keep catching on themselves. I might have to do them one arm at a time. Try holding the actual cables this time instead of the handle, see if that prevents it from catching. Gonna have to use the handles. Hopefully they don't catch like the first set. Mm. just two tricep exercises to finish off. One to hit them in a shortened position, and the other one to hit them in a lengthened position. So you're gonna do overhead rope extensions and then into press downs, superseted together.
Mm.